Good morning, students. Today we discussed about bubble sort. Actually, already discussed. One second, I repeat this bubble sort. Then we move to the selection sort. Okay. Then today we discussed one of the important sorting technique we call it as a quick sort. So these three sorts we discuss it today. Anybody has any doubt regarding previous topics, please write in assessing chat box. So what is bubble sort here? So these are some of the sorting techniques. We have bubble sort, insert sort, shell sort, quick sort, selection sort, merge sort, heap sort, radix sort, stack sort. Okay, but in this today we discussed about only bubble sort, selection sort, and quick sort. Okay, what is bubble sort? So bubble sort can be implemented. Another sorting techniques or any other. So bubble sort will be implemented by using the comparison. Okay, so as here simple and uncomplicated, here largest element placed at last. Okay, so see the example here. First we have to compare 4 and 15. Okay, in first pass here only 4 elements are there. In first pass, the largest element in the given array is placed at last position. Remember, in first pass, the largest element in the given array is placed at last position. In second pass, second largest element. Third pass, third largest. See here, I am taking two loops here, one this one and another is this one. Then I am considering a of j plus one and a of j. Okay, if this condition is true, the swap the elements. Okay, otherwise you cannot swap the elements. Okay, so what it has to do is first it compare these two elements. Okay, if the condition true, the condition true, it will swap. Otherwise it does not swap the elements. Okay, so see here, these two condition false, so no swapping occur. Next it will incremented by 1 and j is incremented by 1, so then the comparison between these two. Okay, here the condition false, so there is a swapping occurs here. Okay, so these two are swapped here. Then next step, these two are compared. When comparing these two, this element is greater than this one, so there is a swapping occur. So here in first pass, the largest element comes in the last position. Similarly, after first pass over, again we start from first position. These two are compared. Condition for true, then swap. There is swap occurs here. Then these two are compared. There is no swapping. Then these three are compared, no swapping. Then these two compare, no swapping, because that number is in correct position only. Okay, in third pass we compare these two, there is no swapping, these two, so we have to check all the array. Okay, so this is about bubble sort. Here this is the algorithm. The clear students, or anybody has any doubt? Next one is selection sort. Okay, so here in selection sort it divide two sublist. One is sorted and another one is unsorted. So search through list and find the smallest element. Okay, so what we have to do in selection sort means, first you have to find the smallest element in the given array. So just replace that element in first position. In bubble sort, we find the largest element. In selection sort, we find the smallest element, and we placed it in first position. And Babul sir?
It was a large statement and placed at last position.
Okay, that is the change. You are clear, students? Okay, clear. See example here. So in this array, what is the shortest element 8? So 8 is in first pass. It will compare this first element with the next element and which one is less. So 23 is compared with 78, 78. 23 is 45 and 23 is compared to 8. Again, so 8 is less, 8 is compared with 32 and 8 is compared with, this is the smallest one. After first pass, the smallest one comes here. Second pass, second smallest, third pass, third smallest. So in this way, after 5 passes, the smallest elements comes in ascending order. See selection sort, see your algorithm. What you have to take here, minimum of j here taken, when the minimum will occur, then you have to swap the element at first position. Okay. Okay, clear students? Okay, clear students, or any doubt? Okay, students, clear or any doubt? Can I move next topic? Next one, very important one is fixer. Okay, next important topic is fixer. So what is quicksort? As compared to bubble sort and selection sort, quicksort works very efficiently as compared to the compared to selection set and bubble set. Okay. The exam. It's first to divide the problem into sub. Our network problem students, please stay. So today we discussed a very important topic, that is uses the divide and conquer technique. Okay, what is divide means? Divide the problem into, see the diagram here. You can understand what is the divide and conquer technique. So here the problem is divided into two sub-problems or some number of sub-problems. Then here solve the solution to the sub-problems. This is the solution to the sub-problem. Then combine. So combine all the solutions of sub-problem. We get the solution to the original problem. The technique here, Kitsar is the technique here. Okay. So here for quick start, so here we use the divide and conquer technique. I already told you how we divide the problem. So here the divide will occur by using the word called as pivot. So pivot will divide the array. into sub parts. Okay, here the pure here step, then you can easily understand what is Quicksort algorithm. Okay, in by constructing, when we are solving the Quicksort algorithm, first you have to choose the pivot element. What is pivot? Pivot element may be a given you have to choose. What is Quicksort? So if you are considering some element, and that element may be the first element in the array or see here, you can clearly understand once you see the diagram here. So this is my array. In this, first you have to choose the pivot element. So pivot element may be first element in the array or last element in the array or middle element in the array or any element in the array. You can choose any element as a pivot. Why we are choose pivot means in Quicksort pivot only, pivot will divide the array into subparts, because in Quicksort we are using divide and conquer approach. So that's why you have to choose the pivot element. Okay, so after choosing the pivot element, next you have to choose the two variables I and J. Okay, clear students? Listen, if any doubt, please write a message. So after choosing the pivot element, then you have to define two variables. That is, those are I and J. See here, I and J means, actually, I means low value, low, or I means A of 0 and J means A of N. That is, I means the starting element of an array, J means the last element of an array, we call it as a I and J. Okay, so when you choose the pivot as the first element, then next element is the pivot as the last element, the next element, the previous element as J. If you choose this one is pivot, this is J. If you choose this one is pivot, this is I. Okay, so in this way, if you choose middle one, then this one I and this one J. Okay, what is I and J means? I is the starting element of array and J is the last element of the array. By depending upon the pivot value, the I and J value position will change once forward or backward position. Okay, clear? So then, see here, after choosing I and J, then you have to increment I until pivot. So A of I greater than pivot, then stop. Okay. The content of I greater than pivot, then stop. If the I less than pivot, just increment. Okay. What does it mean? That see here. Array of element less than pivot. Pivot means choosing pivot element. Increment I. Otherwise, if the condition false, stop. Okay. See, just remember this example. After this step only, you move to the next step. When this condition false only, then you move to the step 4. Until you will not get the false, you just increment I by 1. Increment I plus. Then A of J greater than pivot. Here we are considering J as the last element. That's why we are decrement by 1 until this condition falls. Okay. Whenever A of J less than pivot stop, otherwise J decrement J by 1. Okay, after these two steps are over, then you have to check the index of I and J. Okay, if I less than J, then exchange list I and list J. Okay, index you have to check here index. If I less than J, then you have to exchange list I and list J. Then repeat 3, 4, 5 steps. After swapping again, you consider I, then check I greater than pivot, and check J less than pivot, then stop, then again check the condition I less than J. Okay, if the condition falls, if the condition, this condition falls, then swap pivot and J element. The condition falls, then swap pivot and J element. Okay, clear student, these 5 steps clear, 7 steps clear students. Are any doubt? Please write a message or reply me with a message in chat box. I'm waiting for your reply students. Anyone? Can I move forward? Anyone reply me, students? Listening? Are listening, students? Anyone reply me with a message? These 7 steps are clear. If you are clearly understand these steps, then you solve the Quicksort algorithm, Quicksort just ping me message in chat box. Okay, clear. Okay, thank you. So these 7 steps, remember, first choose the pivot element, then 2 variables, then increment I until this condition falls, decrement J, condition falls, then check the index of I and J. Okay, if condition true, exchange, otherwise repeat steps. Okay, so we will solve Quicksort algorithm with the example. See here, this is my algorithm. This is my example. All of you clearly see what I am doing here. So first, this is my array, 65, 70, 75, 80, 60, 50, 50, 45 is my array. In this, I am choosing the pivot as the first element. So this one is my pivot element. So while I considering the pivot element as the first, the next element is I and the last element is J. Okay, so step one, choose the pivot element. I choose first element as pivot, then choose, then determine 2 variables, that is I. J of I less than pivot, increment I by 1. J of I greater than pivot, okay. J of I greater than pivot, increment I by 1. Okay. Here, 70 is greater than pivot, and 75 is greater than pivot. Sorry, what I told, the condition what I told is A of I less than pivot. So if the A of I less than pivot only means I value is lesser than the pivot, then only you can increment I by 1. Okay, increment you can I by 1. Here 70 is greater than pivot, the condition falls. After step 4, then you. So what is step 5? Check the A of J value. If A of J greater than pivot, if A of I greater than pivot, then decrement J by 1. So 45 is not greater than pivot. So in here, step 4, step 3, step 4 are cover. Here indexes. Okay. After step 4, what we have to check? I and J value. I index is 1 and J index is 8. So I less than 8. Okay, 1 less than 8. What we have to do? Swap the elements of I and J. So 45 comes here and J comes here. Just swap these two. When the condition I less than J condition is true, just swap the contents of I and J. So I and J are stay here only. Only the content will change or the data will change. I and J. Okay. I am moving backwards here. What I am doing? Pivot define, okay, two variables can increment I until A of I greater than pivot. Here in this example, A of I greater than pivot, stop here. Decrement until J less than pivot. Here J less than pivot, then stop here. Then the step 5 is check the index values. I here less than J, condition true. So I value is 1, J value is 8 here. In this example, that is 1 less than a condition to exchange the contents I and J. Okay. After this is power, then repeat 3, 4, 5 steps. Okay. So repeat 3, 4, 5 steps again. Okay. Now I here only, J here only. Okay. Now I value is 45 here. J value is 70. Okay. I less than pivot. So increment I. Okay. Initially, I value here only, J value here only. After checking the condition, this condition is true. I less than pivot, 45 is less than 65. Condition true, increment. J. J stay here. J of J greater than pivot, condition true. Then decrement J by 1. So J. So false, stop here. Then check step 5 is check the index. What is index here? Index is 2. Here index is 7. Index is 2 and index is 7. Swap I and J. Less than 75 is less greater than 2. Okay, network. Condition less than 65, increment I by 1, then I stop here, then see here in this J, 75 greater than pivot, decrement J, then check the index. So this is 3, This one is 6. Okay. So this one is 3. 3 less than 6. Condition true, swap the contents of INJs. Here, these two are swapped here. Sorry, INJ stops here. Okay, these two are stopped here. So 55 comes here. Okay, 55 comes here and 75 comes here. Okay. So then I here only and J here only. Then check the condition. I less than pivot increment I by 1, so 85 I stops here. J less than pivot, 75 greater than pivot, okay. 80 greater than pivot, okay. 60 is not greater than pivot, stop here. So I and J stop here. Then check that 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. 4 less than 5. Check the index here. Consider index only, not the content, just index check. 4 less than 5, condition true, swap these two. So 60 comes here and 85 comes here. So INJ stay here only, just content will change. Okay, so 60 comes here and 85 comes here. Then you have to check the condition here. Okay, I here only, J here only, just J. So I less than pivot, and increment I by 1. So next, see here what the content here. This one is 60 and here 85. So I here only, J here only. So 60 is greater than pivot. So less than pivot, increment I by 1. So I comes here. Then check the condition J. Next 85 less than greater than pivot. So condition false, I stay here. Then check the J. J value is 85. What is the J value is 85. So 85 is greater than 65. Okay, decrement J by 1. So J comes here. 60 is not greater than pivot, so stop. So I J stop here, then check the values. So this one is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I equal to 5, J equal to 4. So here I less than J false, because 4 is not less than 5. So what the condition occur here? I greater than or equal to J. So that is 5 is greater than or equal to 4. So what does it in this case, what you have to do when the condition, this condition is false, that means this condition is true. If false, this is true. So whenever that is false, this condition is false, means just change the pivot element and J element. So what is J? J is 60. What is pivot? 65. Just swap these two. When I greater than or equal to J, in that case only, we swap the pivot element and J. A of J and pivots here. 65 comes here and 60 comes here. Okay. Once the pivot element is changed its position, that means that the elements in the left side of the pivot are lesser than the pivot element, and the elements in the right side are greater than or equal to the pivot element. So that is our divide and conquer technique. Okay, in this way, how to divide the array? Okay. Okay, clear, students? Once the pivot is changed, once the pivot actual position is changed, that means that the elements in the given array are lesser than the left in the given array, less on the left side elements are lesser than the pivot, and right side elements are greater than the pivot. So once you change the pivot, you divide the array in two parts. If the elements are not less than the pivot element in the left side and not greater than the element, means that means you are not correctly follow the all the steps, seven steps. Okay, if you follow all the seven steps, then you correctly divide the array into two subparts. See, here after pivot is changed, This is my left subtree and this is my right subtree. So this is in sorted part. You don't consider this one. Then you consider the left part separately and you are going to do the right part also separately. Okay. You left this one, you just construct left two sublist subarrays. This is one array and this is another array. Next up, what you have to do? Again, you choose the pivot element I and J for this part. Here also you choose the pivot element I and J for this part also. Okay. Okay. Just practice at home. You have any doubt or you just practice now only? If you have any doubt, I will solve your problem. Just I am explaining left part. This is already done right part. Just see what we have to do in the left part. Already I told you, so I directly repeat the step quickly. Don't confuse. Okay. So in this part, the left part, left subtree, right subtree, left part, pivot is 60. I am considering pivoting as the first element. Next element is I. Last element is J. Step one over, step two is also over. Step one choose pivot, step two just determine I and J value. Next step three. If A of I less than pivot, yes, increment A of I less than pivot, yes, increment I by one. And A of I less than pivot, yes. 50 is also less than pivot and 55 is also less than pivot. So I comes here. Here, I comes here. So J greater than pivot, no. I and J are at the same position. I comes here, J 55 not greater than 60, so I and J. So what is the condition here? I greater than or equal to J. Case 2, last step 7, step 7. So greater than J means your index 0, 1, 2, 3. So your index is 3. 3 equal to 3 means condition to then swap pivot and J. So J is 60, pivot is 55. Sorry, J is 55, pivot is 60. Just swap. Here 55 comes here, 60 comes here. That means once the pivot element is changed, so pivot elements from here to here it will come. So that means this is in sorted order. Okay, clear. Then you have to consider here again, you solve the quick set by this subtree. This one is pivot and I, J, then I is incremented here and J stops here. So same condition. So what we have to do is swap pivot and J values. So 50 comes here, 55 comes here. Here also same I and J stay here only, then swap. So this is our sorted and. Clear students, are any doubt? Okay, so consider here in this example, this one is pivot, this is I, and this one is J. Okay, if I less than pivot, yes, so I greater than pivot, no, I less than pivot, yes, increment I by one, I here, I comes here. J greater than pivot, no, so here condition I greater than J will occur. What does mean? Just swap the I and pivot, J and pivot value. So 70 comes here, pivot comes here. So this is our sorted part. Okay, here this is sorted, this one is sorted. Here these two are sorted here. Then these are sorted. Okay. Similarly, see here, this is sorted part. Then these three, this is pivot. I greater than, if I less than pivot, no, and J. J is greater than pivot. Yes, increment J by one. So J comes here. I and j here only, then swap the j and pivot value. So what we have to do is, okay, 75 is greater than 0, yes, j comes here. So swap this I and j value. So what we have to do is, we just consider here 80 here, 70 here, and 75 here. Then pivot ij. Then check the position, then finally get this one. Okay, clear students, or any doubt? If you have any doubt, this is about Pixar. Just you just follow these 7 steps. Just you follow these 7 steps. First, consider the pivot, then determine two different two variables I and j, and increment I until this condition occurs, stop, decrement j, this condition occurs, stop, then check the index value I and j, condition true, exchange, otherwise if this condition falls, then exchange pivot element and the j of j, then again move to the step 3. So this is about Quicksort algorithm. The clear students, are any doubt? Just practice one example, and then you can just write these steps and practice one example. You can clearly understand. Okay. Okay, today we end the session. Students, tomorrow we will discuss the remaining topics. Okay, thank you.